If you were to dive into the ocean, what do you think you would hear? Waves crashing? Bubbles popping and seawater fizzing? What about boats passing by or submarines sending sonar messages? What you might not imagine is that below the ocean waves, there is also an entire world of marine animals making sounds and communicating with one another, just like we do here on land.
It's a funny thing about the ocean. It seems like everybody's heard about whales singing or dolphins making interesting noises. But oftentimes people are really surprised when I say that the ocean is a very noisy place.
Biologist Sheila Patek studies the science of sound, specifically those sounds that you would find in the ocean. Her work is driven by one central question: how does sound in water differ from sound in air?
The reason why it's such a noisy place comes back to the physics of water. Water is very different material, obviously, than air. You could tell just by feeling it. And when sound is produced in water, it travels 5 times more quickly, so you can communicate much more efficiently.
Like water in the ocean, sound travels in waves. These waves carry energy, and when they pass through air, water, or a solid, they create vibrations that we sense as sound. How much energy these waves carry depends on the type of material they're traveling through. Air is a gas, and its molecules are spread very far apart. Water is a liquid, and its molecules are packed much closer together. As a result, water is denser than air, and when sound vibrations pass through water, they can carry more energy over a longer distance.
Most aquatic animals don't sense pressure in pressure waves. Instead, they rely on their whole bodies and their whole body sensation to literally feel the water vibrating around them. And this again comes back to the physics of sound in air versus water.
Imagine an opera singer as she belts out the last line of her song. The glass on a stage shatters. The pressure waves from her voice create vibrations in the glass so strong that you could feel them if you were holding it.
I suppose one way to think about this is, again, if you're at a concert and you have the big speaker sort of blasting sound. One way you're hearing the sound is through your ears. But if you get nice and close to that speaker, you feel the vibration in your body. You can feel the sounds transmitting through your body, and you can feel a lot that way. And in fact, this is how deaf people hear, is literally through feeling the vibrations of their surroundings through their bodies. And this is exactly what most marine organisms are doing.
Sometimes humans can feel vibrations created by sound traveling in air. Marine animals, like spiny lobsters, feel vibrations traveling through water all the time. They even scare away predators by making raspy clicks that create threatening vibrations underwater.
The truth is, this is a frontier. We don't know. Most of our work on sound and animals has been conducted in air and on dolphins and whales. And every time we go into the water, we hear things. We don't know what it is. Nobody knows what it is. And it's an area we don't understand yet.
Want to learn more about how marine animals communicate in the ocean? Check out the Sounds in the Sea Design Challenge on the Curiosity Machine.